Today, we are ranking all proposed line extensions in the JUTPI3 map based on urgency, aka which one should be built first. And because we have plenty new lines and extensions to rank, we are gonna do this speedrunner style. Starting with the important tier, we have the Tangerang Ciputat line, providing much needed rapid transit to Alam Sutera, Kaharaya, Bintaro Jaya, and Ciputat. Important, but the reason it doesn't score higher is the congestion in Bintaro Jaya and Kaharaya is, well, it can get bad, but they are much worse places. Congestion in Ciputat can get bad, but the place is somewhat close to the Rangkas Bitung line, which already exists, and the proposed MRT extension to Ciputat. Next, we have the KRL Eastern Loop. Important because it serves population dense but underserved areas like Jonggol. Important also because it diverts freight trains away from the city center. But the reason why this is a tier below the Western Loop is, notice how the Cikarang and Bogor line meet at a 90 degree angle, which isn't very sharp. So while using this line to get between Cikarang and Bogor can save time, it is not as big of a time save as the Western Loop. Moving to the two local trains, the Jonggol and Lewiliang local trains. Important because it serves isolated areas, but it is not going any higher since it mainly serves less population dense areas. Next, we have the only line that doesn't require new tracks, the JIS line connecting Tanjung Priok with Jatinegara using existing KRL commuter line tracks. Important because it provides additional service to the notoriously infrequent Tanjung Priok and eastern side of the loop of the Cikarang line. Seriously, 30-minute frequency is diabolical for a line that goes through central Jakarta. Last is the Bogor tram, which I considered putting in the useless tier, but if paired with the Bogor Loop LRT, which does most of the heavy lifting, it makes sense. While the Loop LRT focuses on bringing people from the edges of Bogor City to the city center, the tram acts like an inner city shuttle, connecting the train station with the Botanical Gardens and Botani Square Mall. Also, Transpakuan buses are so full they can't accept more passengers at rush hour, so clearly there's demand. Now, of course, there are challenges. How would a tram navigate Bogor's notoriously chaotic streets? Say, tram must also be able to climb steep hills. But those are solvable problems. Moving to the very important tier, we have the Tangerang line extension to Kutabumi, a densely populated area filled with houses and factories. And the roads here are quite small, which means awful congestion. This is definitely the way to solve congestion there instead of adding more lanes. And the large number of factories means that morning trains bound for Kutabumi have the potential to be filled up. Moving to the KRL Western Loop, the other loop which I said is a tier higher, it's higher because South Tangerang, Depok, and Bogor are actually not that far apart on the map, but you need this stupid detour to central Jakarta. This gets rid of the problem and provides an alternative to the crazy expensive second outer ring road. Next is the LRT Jakarta circular line, forming a convoluted and squished loop around central Jakarta, and it has a tail that connects this whole thing to the high-speed rail. Important because it provides an alternative to Transjakarta, which is overloaded and requires multiple transfers. It also provides an alternative to severely congested roads, most notably the whole mess within Jalan Panjang, Daan Mogot, and the KRL Tangerang line, and the whole Sunter area. Next, we have the Bogor LRT loop line. Important as it goes through Bogor's severely congested streets, and clearly there's demand, judging by the fact that angkot are passing by every couple of seconds, and that Transpakuan buses are overloaded at rush hour. But why doesn't it go to IPB main campus? It's like 3 kilometers from Wulak Terminal. Moving to the LRT Jabodebek extensions, the Bekasi line is to be extended to Cikarang, while the Cibubur line is to be extended to Bogor. Important because it connects places like Grand Wisata, Lippo Cikarang, and Sentul to rapid transit, but I have some concerns on the LRT's speed problem. Transjakarta P11 has a higher average speed than the LRT Cibubur line. On the way back, I calculated the average speed between Cibubur Junction and Tegal Mampang, and I got an average speed of 42, which is quite a lot faster than the LRT, running mostly parallel to the section of this line. When your train is slower than the bus, we have a problem. Before we extend this LRT, we gotta fix the trains. Next is the Bekasi LRT. It runs north-south through the heart of Bekasi city and it has a problem. Why does it stop short at Bantar Gebang? It should be extended further south until it meets the Cileungsi line, and maybe also make a detour to Living World Kota Wisata. In its current shortened state, it stays in this tier. If there's a revision to JUTPI3 with said extension, it will move up to the build this ASAP tier because we desperately need more circumferential suburb to suburb transit. Last is the MRT Jakarta North-South line extensions. A southern extension to Ciputat and Pondok Cabe and a northern extension to Ancol. This route layout is a no-brainer. connect densely populated and congested Ciputat with the Sudirman Tamrin CBD and the Ancol tourist area. The only reason why it isn't in a higher tier is because all of these places already have transit. Moving to the build this as soon as possible tier, we have the Pulau Gebang Tangerang LRT, passing by notoriously congested roads such as Casablanca, Dr. Satrio, and Raya Cipondo. This line looks like it's basically designed to end the suffering of Transjakarta 5F, 6D, and 11Q users. Next, we have the Depok Tangerang LRT. Am I biased? Yes, because this passes by Gading Serpong. Passes by congested roads like Serpong Raya, which apparently can also go underwater if it rains too hard, and Siliwangi. In terms of congestion, not as serious as the roads served by the Pulau Gebang Tangerang line, but it makes up for this by providing desperately needed circumferential suburb-to-suburb connections. My only concern is that due to the way Serpong is built, with many facilities and people located deep inside developments and far from Serpong Raya, a strong feeder bus system is definitely needed to maximize ridership. Next is the Depok Cileungsi line. Well, one criticism, this line needs to be extended to Mekarsari, where it can meet up with the KRL Eastern Loop. Like alright, they're separate in the JUTPI3 map, but when I tried to map these lines, they're basically within spitting distance. Maybe I mapped the KRL Eastern Loop wrong, since information on it is very limited, so I'm practically forced to guess where it goes, but Cileungsi and Mekarsari are so close at this map scale that they look like they should connect, and well, they should. But besides that, Transyogi's congestion is awful and we need more suburb-to-suburb transit. This can also connect up with the Bekasi line and strong feeder services are required, especially to connect this line with the inside of Kota Wisata. MRT Airport Depok line. This line passes through areas of disastrous congestion such as Sawangan, Gatot Subroto, Semanggi, and Esparman. Sawangan is a place where a 3-kilometer trip can take half an hour. Semanggi is one interchange where you can get stuck there for 15 to 30 minutes on a bad day. This line also serves Pantai Indah Kapuk, a place known for being a tourist attraction, severe congestion, and being very far from any kind of train. There are only two lines left, being the MRT East-West line and the MRT Outer Loop line. But only one can claim a spot in first priority tier. The line, I believe, should be built first. But before that, let's get to know our candidates. MRT East-West line starts in Balai Raja, making its way through the severely congested Jakarta Merak Highway, reaching the Tomang Interchange, making an S-shaped maneuver that covers Central Park, Roxy, Tanah Abang, and Tamrin, following Transjakarta Corridor 2 until Pulau Gadung, going beyond Corridor 2 all the way to Cikarang, where it meets the KRL Cikarang line. This line connects all the rapid transit deprived areas like Balai Raja, Lipo Karawaci, Gading Serpong, Alam Sutera, and the entirety of Northern Bekasi City, and funnels all these people into the heart of Jakarta. Meanwhile, the MRT Outer Loop starts in Pantai Indah Kapuk, follows the first Outer Ring Road until Tanjung Priok, before then following the Tanjung Priok line to Jakarta Kota. Most importantly, it serves the severely congested Tbc Matupang, and it allows connections to the Tangerang, Rengkas Bitung, North-South, Bogor, Cibubur, Bekasi, Cikarang, and Tanjung Priok lines. No more wasteful city center detours for suburb-to-suburb travel. My verdict? The MRT Outer Loop line wins. This is the line that we should drop everything and build. I say this as someone who will technically benefit more from the East-West line. We need this loop line. A loop line would supercharge all existing lines. Someone from Serpong who wants to go to Bogor no longer needs to go to Central Jakarta. They will actually take the train instead of speeding in their top-heavy SUVs in the second Outer Ring Road. My only criticism is that it's not actually a loop. Instead of terminating in Jakarta Kota, this line should just follow top Labuhan, enter Peak 1, and meet with itself, forming a perfect loop which will be very satisfying on the map and solve the severe congestion problem on top Labuhan.